Hi everyone, how do you do? If I show you this picture, most of you would think that I have designed it in Illustrator. But what if I tell you I have designed it in PowerPoint? Today I'm going to show you how to design this beautiful vector picture in PowerPoint and how to animate it from winter to summer by only one click. We want to create this vector picture, so let's do it together. First, let me draw a big circle. Don't forget to hold the Shift key down while drawing a circle and align it to the middle and center. If you want to add a tool to the Quick Access toolbar, you can easily right-click on your tool and select Add to Quick Access toolbar. Now add a rectangle the size of the slide. Okay, send it back. Select rectangle and then the circle, and subtract the circle from it, and change its color. Click on the Arrange icon and select the selection pane, and rename the shape to cover. Now it is time to draw the big cloud. Draw a circle and duplicate it and adjust it like this. Repeat this process like me. Hold the Ctrl key down and select all the circles. From Shape Format tab, click on the Merge Shapes icon and make them union. Now all the circles converted into one shape. Select the freeform shape and draw like this. Select both shapes and make them union. Send it back and change the name of shape to Cloud 1. And change its color to the light blue. Now you have to draw the second cloud. Select all the circles and make them union. If selecting is hard for you, hold the Ctrl key down and select all the circles from the selection pane. Again, select the freeform shape and draw like this. Select both shapes and make them union and change its name to Cloud 2. And drag it one layer down. Okay, let's add other shapes to the slide. Don't forget to rename each shape. First, let's draw the third hill and rename it. Repeat this process for hill 2 and 1, respectively. Draw the moon and cloud as well. For the cloud, we use the same approach that we did for other clouds. Select all the circles and make them union. Now rename all the shapes and rearrange the order layer like this. In the selection pane, everything should be under the cover layer. Hill 1 is first, put hill 2 under it, and then hill 3. Press Ctrl A and remove the outline from all the shapes. While all the shapes are selected, add drop shadow to all of them and modify the amount of shadow size and blur like this. Change each shape color accordingly. Select light blue for hill 3 and moon and choose white for other shapes. Draw a rectangle the size of the slide and change its name to background. Okay, send it back and add a gradient fill to it and change its color like this. Make sure that the linear type is selected and the direction of gradient is correct. For the second color, I want a darker blue. So click on More Colors and make it a little darker. Click on OK. It is time to add some trees to the shape. From Insert tab, click on Icons and search for Tree. Select these two trees and click on Insert. While both shapes are selected, click on Convert to Shape. Make some copies of them and put each tree behind its heel. Change the tree's color as you wish. For this one, I want dark blue, so pick eyedropper and choose this color. Alright, everything looks perfect. Press Ctrl A and group all the shapes. I will explain why I grouped all the shapes. It is time to add some snow to the shape. Draw a small circle and define its size like this. Rename it snow and make some copies of it and spread them on the shape. Increase the size of one snow a little bit and repeat the process. Alright, now I want to group all the snow shapes. Press Ctrl A and hold the Ctrl key down and deselect the grouped shapes. Press Ctrl G to group all the snow shapes. Okay, now you can ungroup all the shapes. I think you found out why we grouped all the shapes earlier. Because if we hadn't grouped them, instead of deselecting the group, we had to deselect all the shapes one by one. Anyway, if you have shapes that a part of it is protruded from the slide, draw a rectangle and subtract the shape from it. First, subtract rectangle from heel tree and draw another rectangle and subtract it from another heel. And repeat this process for the last heel. Since we subtracted the heels from rectangles, their names in the selection pane are changed, so we need to rename them again. Congratulations, the vector image is ready. Now you can easily save this picture as a vector file or other formats. Press Ctrl A and right click on the shape and select Save as Picture. In the Save as Type section, you can select different formats, such as PNG, JPG, and the SVG format, which is the vector format. In this case, select PNG and save it on your desktop. Now, if you look at your desktop, you can see your picture. Isn't it awesome? In this part of video, I want to animate this shape from winter to summer, like this. I'm going to do that with only the help of the morph transition. You have to notice that the order of objects is important. Duplicate the slide and remove all the snow shapes from the slide. Drag all the trees down and hide them. It is better to rotate them because it will look better with morph transition. I have painted this tree and I want to add some of them to the slide. Make two copies of the tree and rename them. Put each tree behind its heel in the selection pane. Now, if I apply morph transition to the second slide, you can see the result. But there is a problem. No animation applies to the trees. Why? Remember, if you want morph animation on all the shapes, you have to have all of them in both slides. So for solving this problem, copy all the trees and paste them into the previous slide. And in the selection pane, put each tree behind its heel and hide them. Now if I preview the morph transition,
it is better. Now we have to drag the moon out of the picture and add the sun to it. From the Insert tab, click on Icon and search for Sun and add it to the slide. Change its name to Sun and drag its layer down. Now change the color of shapes in the slide. Copy the sun and paste it in the previous slide and change its position. And don't forget to bring its layer down. Alright, the animation is ready. But if you want more animation, you have to animate each shape individually. For example, if I add a spin animation to the sun, you can see that the sun is rotating. But I want a slow rotation, so I increase duration to 30 seconds. You might say, what about a snow? How to animate it? For animating a snow, select the snow group and ungroup it. And while all the snow shapes are selected, make them union. Duplicate the snow and drag it a little up. Select both shapes and make them union again and duplicate it. Drag both snow shapes out of the picture and add lines animation to them. Adjust the lines like this. This adjustment will help you to have continuous snowing. Select Start with Previews and 10-second duration for both shapes and 5-second delay for the second shape. Select both animation and right-click on them and select Timing. In the Repeat section, select Until End of a Slide and in the Effect tab, set 0 for a smooth start and a smooth end. Click on OK. Now you can see this beautiful animation.
I hope you enjoyed this video, but today's video was about morph transition. In future, I will make a video about how to animate all the shapes in the slide individually. If you think this video was helpful, please like and subscribe to the channel and ring the notification bell for additional upcoming videos. Alright, it was all for today's video. I'll see you in next video.